Yesterday, we have seen the Indian government has taken a decision to merge BSNL, MTNL as a one entity and make it strong. And to make it strong, the government has taken initiative steps to make it the entire BSNL and MTNL viable, profitable and survive. How it is possible? What the government is thinking about it? I think the government wants to disinvest some of the shares of these two corporates, PSUs, and invite and allow private management to take over and to look after the future operations and continue the activity. But in our opinion, we suggest that the BSNL and MTNL are having very huge valued assets of lands, buildings, fiber capacity, fiber network capacity, and also towers, and so much of having a very much big capacity, very much not only technologically as well as properties, buildings and locations also. And those are highly values are increased multiple times, so that it will be advantageous if that properties are retained with the organizations and see that all the ownership still continues with these organizations and government also continues to that. Alternatively, what we can say is it's better to invite investors to make these two organizations combined unit, combined organization as survived, revived and made profitable. And the investors should come with the sufficient funds to meet the administrative expenditure as well as to meet repayment schedule as per loans agreed, loans taken from the financial institutions, banks, etc. This is in such a situation, these corporations, these PSUs are having huge value of wealth, building and other assets, lands, etc. But they doesn't have sufficient money. Sufficient flow of funds, sufficient revenue to make the units survive profitably. So who the organization which comes into as an investor brings sufficient money can make these organizations profitable and viable, making only marginal amounts, means we can say 1/4 of the existing asset value can be invested to make these units perform profitably, successfully, and also to smooth functioning also. Is it possible? We can say, we can try from this. See, our majority of the public sector undertakings are having the properties of land, building, and other assets, which are highly valuable now, which are increased. Of course, their loans are also outstanding, but when the compared to the loans, these properties values are highly valued. So in such circumstances, we advise the government to retain its ownership and to invite investments from private parties and private investors, and also to look after the management so that the existing management can be continued as well as the new management, means to meet the more effective performance, to reach the highest goals, to enhance its productivity and earning capacity, revenue capacity. New investors will come with sufficient, because try once before disinvestment. We advise the government, try once to call for investors to meet the working capital requirement as well as to enhance the capacity, means service capacity, means data capacity are competent to other private telecom companies, as well as to meet the repayment schedule with the financial institutions. This may initiation may protect the investments of government, properties held by these companies, these organizations, and of course after these units become profitable and viable, the government can go for disinvestment where the government can get higher price of their shares held by the government, and that will be more profitable. If we wait for some time, 2 or 3 years, now we have waited, there have been 3 to 5 years we are waiting, and one more 2 or 3 more years also may give good results of patients are waiting to the companies and as well as to the government through disinvestment. Thank you.